It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Hello, comrades. This is Chetty here, and welcome to Chetty's 12 Days of Christmas, the series where we take a look at 12 different Christmas movies, break them down, and give you an idea of what to expect if you are going to watch them. And today, I'm going to be taking a look at the entirety of the Silent Night, Bloody Night trilogy, if you could even call it that. Not to be confused with the Silent Night, Deadly Night series. The Silent Night, Bloody Night franchise is a slasher series that spanned over the course of 5 decades, and believe it or not, these movies are actually worse than those of the Silent Night, Deadly Night fame, because at least with those movies, while not very good, they took risks and kept things interesting. The same cannot be said about these films. More or less, all three of them are kind of the exact same thing, so without further ado, let's get right into it. The first film in the trilogy, simply titled Silent Night, Bloody Night, was released in 1972, and it follows a series of murders that occur in a small New England town on Christmas Eve after a man inherits a family estate that was once an insane asylum. And at first glance, this may appear to be one of those films that has a small yet devoted fan base, but that couldn't be further from the truth. In fact, over the years, the film has been panned for kind of being a boring mess of a movie, and that's most likely due to the disastrous production that took place while filming the film. To be fair, there are certain things that deserve some praise for the film. For one, the movie captures a very moody, surreal, yet confusing vibe that I haven't really seen much of in these holiday horror films. It should also be noted, from my research, this appears to be one of, if not the first horror movie set around the holiday itself, which is pretty cool. It's also very clear that Black Christmas took a great deal of influence from this film that was released in 1974, and it's regarded by many as the first mainstream American slasher. Although, it should be noted that both Black Christmas and Silent Night, Bloody Night take a great deal of inspiration from Italian horror films such as A Bay of Blood. But while Black Christmas took the idea of the slasher subgenre and laid the groundwork for what an American-made version of that should look like, Silent Night, Bloody Night more or less just did the exact same thing, resulting in it kind of falling into obscurity and not really meshing well with what audiences wanted around the time. Still though, if the property had just been left on its own, it would have been a very cool time capsule of the early 70s of what the slasher genre looked like pre-Black Christmas and Texas Chainsaw and Halloween. But they had to go ahead and pump out some sequels, and that brings us to the next film in the series. Silent Night, Bloody Night, The Homecoming was released in 2013 and is a remake of the original 1972 film. The plot, again, is kind of just the exact same thing. Guy inherits something and people start to get murdered. Except this time there is a mass killer, which, to be honest with you, kind of disappointed me, because one of the best aspects of the original was the very surreal style of it all, and I wish they had translated that over to this remake, because it could have made it stand out amongst a sea of very similar horror films that were coming out during this time period. But rather, instead of continuing the vibe that the first film had going for it, they more or less just made a very standard slasher. Granted, I don't think the film is horrible. I would go as far to say this is probably the most fun film, the most entertaining one in the trilogy. I do think the first one is definitely the best just because of the novelty of it. It has a really cool energy to it that you don't see much of in these Christmas horror films. But this is basically just your standard slasher affair. I will say, they didn't really have much of a budget with this, and some of the stuff that they were able to do with said budget is kind of impressive. You know, there's some decent kills in here, some interesting shots. Although, to be honest with you, this is just alright. You know, I think the whole reason why this was made was to cash in on the success of the Silent Night, Deadly Night remake, which had come out a year prior in 2012. And again, standard slasher here. Not great, not bad. For the budget, it's alright, but it's still miles better to the third film, and bringing that up, let's just get right into it. And the third and final film in the trilogy is Silent Night, Bloody Night 2, The Revival. And yes, you heard that right, this is a sequel. The film was released in 2014, although it should be noted this is not a sequel to the 2013 movie, which, keep in mind, came out less than a year prior, but rather to the original 1972 film. Now, to be honest with you, I was very confused at first, and then I discovered that the original film is registered under public domain, And then it all kind of made sense to me. I will say, I do kind of like the fact that they went the Halloween 2018 route before that was kind of even a thing. I do think Texas Chainsaw 3D definitely deserves the recognition for sort of putting that idea to the forefront where you ignore all the films in the series besides the original. And I do appreciate the fact that they did that here, and that's probably the one edge this has over the Homecoming. But at the same time, they don't really bother to, you know, complete the story or follow up to the continuity of the original. So it kind of basically negates itself in that aspect. The positives with this film are very few and far between. I will say I do kind of dig the grindhouse aesthetic at times, and I think the black Santa suit looks kind of cool under certain circumstances. But other than that, this movie is kind of just a mess, to be honest with you. I really hate the fact that they reuse footage from the old film to show flashbacks. I usually wouldn't have a problem with that in a film like this. But again, the continuity doesn't line up whatsoever. The original film, it was just some random person killing people. Now it's a killer Santa, which just is a bit too much, especially for this series. Still though, again, I'm not going to hate on this movie too much. It's very clear they didn't have much of a budget here. But to be honest, this is just the most confusing one to me, because if they truly were fans of the franchise and they wanted to make this a direct sequel to the original, they could have bothered to at least try to see some resemblance between the two films, but they kind of just did whatever they wanted here. And for that, it's hands down the worst film of the franchise. So in the end, what did we learn about the Silent Night, Bloody Night series? If you said it sucks, you are most certainly right. The original film is very bad. But with the name very synonymous with another big horror series, and the fact that the original film is published under public domain, it only made sense that filmmakers would eventually come along to try to cash in on the success of this. Which, to be honest, I don't really fully get. The original 72 film is very obscure. I would say the people who made these movies are fans, but the style or surrealism don't really line up that we saw in the original. So it kind of just leaves this series feeling very strange, and it serves no greater purpose other than to provide a guideline on how not to make a sustainable slasher franchise. Anyways, guys, that is the video. If you did enjoy it, as always, make sure to drop a like and subscribe. I will see you guys very soon with some brand new content. We have a couple more episodes of Chetty's 12 Days of Christmas coming out, so definitely stay tuned for that. Anyways, I'll see you guys soon with a brand new video. This is Chetty signing off. Peace out.